on the scene at Bridgestone Arena is Conor McGahey. He is the radio voice of the Colorado Avalanche. And Conor, let's start with that Avalanche roll. They are rolling right now, winning four straight and scoring in bunches. Why are they having so much success offensively right now?
Well, it's got to start with the top line, but I would go back to that second period, EJ, in Anaheim last Sunday. They're down 3-1. Ever since that second period, they've outscored the opposition 18-6. And so the big line, obviously, they're at 99 points so far this season. And if they don't have a point in the game, the Avalanche aren't winning. But for the Avs, they're able to put everything together. Tied for the most power play goals in the National Hockey League. And they've also tied Calgary now, 35 goals in the third period. So they've been down in games, have been able to come back. So they're scoring in all types of situations. And we talk about Landeskog, Rantanen, and MacKinnon all the time, but you've got contributions from guys like Carl Soderberg, JT Compher, Alexander Kerfoot, and more. The depth of scoring was a big talking piece before the season began, and that's helped out. It's led by the big line for the Avalanche, but it's been a total team effort, and everything is clicking right now on their longest win streak of the season.
And you mentioned Compher. He seems to be settling back in after missing the start of the season to injury. What has he had to say about his play?
Well, believe it or not, as far as goals per games go, with a minimum of 5 goals scored, he's third in the NHL. 6 goals in 7 games played. That's behind Patrick Laine and Austin Matthews. Austin Matthews has 10 goals in 11 games. Laine, 19 in 22 games. He's only played 7 games, we know, but when he's on the ice, he scores. He scored in 3 games in a row, despite the fact that one of those was before he got hurt, before the Calgary game back in October. But he's turned into a real pure sniper for the Colorado Avalanche. He's been a great addition, building on the performance that he had last year. And JT Compher has been a welcome return for the Colorado Avalanche.
All right, let's get to the crease now. Semyon Varlamov and Philipp Grubauer have both been effective when called upon this season. How have each been able to stay consistent while, you know, splitting time to a certain degree?
EJ, I asked Jared Bednar that very question this morning, and he said, I like to play the rest of goalie, and I like to play the goalie that has a history versus the opponent that we're playing. For Semyon Varlamov, he'll go tonight against the Nashville Predators. He's actually done pretty well inside the Central Division. Philipp Grubauer, obviously most of his career with the Washington Capitals, will go tomorrow night versus a very familiar opponent and the Pittsburgh Penguins. So Varlamov playing last Saturday, the second of a back-to-back against the Dallas Stars. That was 14 wins all time versus Dallas. That's the most out of any opponent. So it's sort of a chess match, and it's also playing the rest of goaltender, and that's what you can do with a true 1-1-A situation the Avs have in their goal crease.
All right, let's go to Twitter for a question for you about these Avalanche, and here we go. Are the Avalanche, given their current construction and talent pipeline, on a similar path as the team they're playing tonight, the Nashville Predators?
Well, we've talked ad nauseum about how deep the Nashville Predators are as far as their system goes. Sam Girard, who you will see on the ice tonight, is one of the brightest young talents as far as defensemen go. And the Nashville Predators, because they are so deep, were able to part with him. The Avalanche are getting stronger. They're one of two teams that have 2 first-round picks coming up in this year's draft. So they are getting deeper. You have prospects like Connor Timmins, Cale Makar, Shane Bowers coming up to the system. So even a couple years ago, you were talking about how the well was dry for the Avs. It's starting to fill up a lot now, and Joe Sakic has done a nice job of putting a good product on the ice and having plenty of talent in the system to be ready to go for years to come.
All right, Conor, thanks for your time. We appreciate it. Should be a great game tonight, Avalanche and Predators. It's the dad's trip for the Avalanche, so should be a fun night there. Enjoy the game.
Well, dude, thanks, guys.